On July 16, 1983, in Saluzzo, Italy, Comunità Cianacola was born when Mother Alvira opened a house to welcome drug addicts and desperate youth searching for a better life. In 1993, with the help of Bishop Robert Baker, the first American house, Our Lady of Hope, was opened in St. Augustine, Florida. After having had some initial struggles, the community in America prospered, and it continues to grow today. Two more houses were opened in St. Augustine: Mary Immaculate and St. Maria Goretti for women. The most recent house to be open is Our Lady of Joyful Hope near Birmingham, Alabama. Comunità Cianacolo currently has 67 houses worldwide, including mission houses for orphaned and abandoned children. In Comunità Cianacolo, we live a simple, Christian, family life. Through work, prayer, and friendship, many of us have experienced an authentic encounter with Jesus. In community, we do not have distractions of the modern world, such as cell phones, television, and internet. We can more easily focus on the true causes of our addiction and turn to God, the only one who can heal us. Comunità Cianacolo offers to each young man and woman the discovery of work to be lived as a gift. We no longer work for money. Through working together, we learn to communicate more effectively, accept the ideas of others, and resolve conflicts. Many of us discover gifts and talents that we never knew we had. And we learn that love is the best motivation for doing a job well. We learn the meaning of true friendship in community. Relationships must be based on truth. There are no doctors or psychiatrists, no staff, and no medications. We develop healthy relationships with one another by becoming vulnerable and expressing our true feelings. We speak the truth to each other, both when it's hard to say it and when it's hard to hear it. The heart of Comunità Cianacolo is prayer. 3 rosaries a day, the Holy Mass, and Eucharistic Adoration provide the foundation for an intimate encounter with Jesus, who we come to realize is the true and only solution to our problems. Through His mercy, we come to know and embrace our brokenness, faults, and gifts, humbly seeking for Him to become the center of our lives. Comunità Cianacolo has flourished from its humble beginnings over 30 years ago. Drug addicts, men and women who are desperate and lost, now give their lives through different vocations. Some get married and live their family life in community. Others have felt the call to the consecrated life, becoming religious brothers, sisters, and even ordained priests of Cianacolo. Many of our young men and women have chosen to serve poor, abandoned, and neglected children at our mission houses in Liberia, Peru, Mexico, and Brazil. The community lives on the providence of God, knowing and trusting that the Father, who is loving and kind, will give His children all that we need. We receive no funds from the government or the diocese, nor do we ask payment of anyone living in community. Instead, God's providence sustains us through the gifts and contributions of those who desire to help in this work of God's mercy. Mother Alvira abandoned herself to the Father in total trust, convinced that He would lead, protect, and bless His work. The Father faithfully and abundantly responded to her yes with an outpouring of mercy, which has transformed countless desperate lives into lives of hope and joy immersed in the saving love of Jesus. With the growth of Comunitat Chinakalo beyond diocesan and national boundaries, many bishops throughout Europe and the world, in whose diocese we were present, urged us to begin a journey of pontifical recognition of the work. On October 16, 2009, Comunitat Chinakalo became an international association of the faithful of pontifical right. We also enthusiastically share in the mission of the church by evangelizing through biblical dramas, some of which are developed and performed by individual houses. We presented our biggest production, Credo, at World Youth Day in Poland, the Youth Festival in Medjugorje, and at our very own Festival of Life in Saluzzo, Italy. These representations of the gospel help us to live Christ's message of salvation as a living prayer.